It's Thursday. Gotta get down on Thursday. Toast. I'm happy today, and you know why? It's because I am excited, because I get to go see the premiere showing of Guardians of the Galaxy tonight. And that's the movie I am second most excited about this summer. First, of course, being Ninja Turtles next week. So, yeah, that'll be cool. But still, Guardians of the Galaxy looks awesome. Can't wait to see it tonight. And I love that they stopped doing the premiere showings at midnight and now you can see them earlier. I mean, that's awesome. And this is like a new thing. I mean, with Captain America 2, I was able to see like a 9 p.m. showing and not have to stay up all night on a Thursday, which is just great. Oh boy, I remember how hard it used to be, like back when X-Men and X-Men 2 came out back in the day. Went to those midnight showings and then I had to go to school the next morning. So tired, you know. Did that for Spider-Man 2. Did it for that Ninja Turtles movie, you know, just TMNT. What else? I even saw Wreck-It Ralph midnight showing. So, yeah, and Avengers, too. But I'm so glad that, you know, I get to see Guardians of the Galaxy at 7:45. That is awesome. That is just awesome, and I love they're doing that. So, yeah, you're going to see Guardians of the Galaxy? Let me know in the comments. Let me know what you think of the movie. So, toast. Anyway, can't wait to see it. Today's Daily Toast, Sonic Riders for the GameCube. This is a game that I feel is very much an acquired taste. It is a game that I feel like nobody likes. Yet, Sonic Riders is just everywhere. I mean, they put it on the PS2, on the Xbox, on the PC, and it's in some compilations, and Sonic Riders got two sequels. It's got action figures, it's got remote control cars, it's got theme songs. I feel like they're really pushing Sonic Riders, but I know very few people that really like Sonic Riders. Toast. So, yeah, honestly, I got really hardcore into this game, but I really started to like it because I had a friend who was into it also, and racing each other, I wasn't crazy about the multiplayer. There's so much going on the screen of this that, you know, when you have it split screen, it's tough. But, you know, just have someone to switch off with, doing all the different missions and challenges, it makes the game a lot more fun. Everything's more fun with friends, right? Toast. So what this game is, it's like Back to the Future. You know, you got hoverboards that Sonic's racing on against the Babylon Rose. First appearance of Chet the Hawk, Storm the Albatross, and Wave the Swallow. Which, look, I got my cool action figures, those guys right here. See, I've got Chet around here somewhere too, but toast. Cool characters. I like the Babylon Rogues. I really do. I think the Babylon Rogues were so much cooler than Shadow or Silver when it came to, you know, new rivals for Sonic. Because Shadow is just another hedgehog, and Silver is just another hedgehog, whereas Jet, he's a bird, and he doesn't run. He flies on a hoverboard, which was cool, and Jet is such a cool personality because he's all cocky. You're supposed to be the fastest thing alive, ha! You know? That's good. You know, he pushes Sonic's buttons like that. I think that's so cool. And this game has a full-on story. It's got some great animation in there. Well, you know, it's got some really good CG animation. Then it's got, like, this in-game animation where the characters look like, wow, we're robots, you know. It's really weird. But then it's got some really interesting stuff in here with the story and, like, this whole thing with the Babylon Garden that rises and this cube thing and their Chaos Emeralds and all kinds of crazy, crazy stuff. But then it's got this cartooniness to it, too. Now, all the characters got this special move. Like, Tails pulls out this giant, like, plug, you know, you plug into your outlet. It's like he electrocutes people with it. Of course, Amy's got her hammer. And what's Knuckles do? Knuckles, like, his head turns really big. And he, like, rah, like, screams at you or something. It's so silly and funny. And then Sonic, you know, every character has their little special move. And Sonic, he gets off the board and just does his spin dash, and you're way faster. Sonic is way faster than he is on a board, which is cool. And you get used to this game, you learn how to do all these crazy tricks. I don't like that you have to keep refilling your air by twisting your joystick at these certain parts, and that just really wears out your control. It's, you know, Mario Party all over again, you know, just twisting that joystick around and around and around, get your air. It's much easier if you just do tricks to get your air. Oh, then the unlockable characters. It was crazy, wasn't it, to find Knights is a playable character in this to unlock, and you also get Amigo, or no, not Amigo. You get I from Monkey Ball, and Ooh La La. That was weird to see Ooh La La in this game. Oh, the Sega Carnival level. There's a Sega Carnival level you unlock that just takes you through all these different Sega games. Like, there's a little Monkey Ball area. There's a part where you actually get in the back of the taxi from Crazy Taxi. And I think, is it Axel or BD Joe? I want to say it's Axel who drives you around. Maybe it's BD Joe. I don't remember. But that's a lot of fun, too. This game's a lot of fun because you can unlock a whole lot of characters, whole lot of missions, like, after you get absolutely everything done, which takes forever. You know, you pull all-nighters just doing all these missions in this game. Then you get Supersonic. So I finally get Supersonic, and I really could never get used to Supersonic. So instead of running on air, you run on rings. And here I am, you know, practicing all this time on doing all these tricks to get air. I never really focused on the rings, so therefore it's a lot harder to play a Supersonic when you're so used to playing a different way. Oh well. Oh well. Toast. So this game is so cool because in the story, you know, you're about to win the last race, and then boom, in the middle of the race, it jumps to this cutscene where is like a booby trap in the middle of the race, and Sonic like hits the trap and Jet wins the race. So for the sake of story, they sabotage you in the actual game, which was really like, whew, eye-opening. It's like, you know, a little bit of what the heck moment, but still, it was cool overall, because then that leads into this really nice CG cutscene of Jet winning like the cube thing and rising the Babylon Garden, and of course he's betrayed by Dr. Robotnik, who takes everything, and then Amy runs and jumps onto the back of his Eggomatic and flies up. So then of course Sonic and everyone's got to go up there and save Amy and save the world and everything. I like this game, I really do, and it's really worth playing this game, you know, to get to know the controls, get to know the courses, and get really good at this game. Just if you're a Sonic fan and you want to know the story and want to see all the cool CG cutscenes. Of course, that doesn't really matter these days because you can just watch them all on the internet, but oh well, it's a lot more fulfilling when you do it yourself. So thanks for watching Daily Toast, and tune in tomorrow for another one.